This example shows how validation in ASP.NET works. What we see here is our edit form, and inside there, when we have this article field or field where we may enter something, text or title, if we leave it empty and save it, then there comes up a validation message which says, okay, that the field is required. Where does this come from and how do we do this validation? First, for validation, we need in the model some attributes, for example, the required attribute or the max length, and we set this, we place this straight before a field itself. So this belongs to this article name. So this is in the model. And in the view, we have to do the following. We have to set this, let's say, a frame div ASP validation summary. That's which says that that in total something is going wrong. And below, following to each input field, we have this span ASP validation for, and there we set the same. We set it to the field required, which is in the input field before, and the class therefore is default text danger, which comes from the Bootstraps class. And finally, when we send back this form to ASP Action, we have there edit at postback is in this case the return action. And we go to the controller. Then we use there the if model state is valid, which this one is invalid when something is wrong at that point. So if everything is okay, then we should do our work. And otherwise we go back to the same view and return the form data on there. So we run it once. Now we go to this, to the index, we open one entry, and then when we delete that stuff there and come back, then the validation text message will come up. And in the previous version, MVC5, we had which we were writing at, so this is the razor HTML dot validation message for, and then m goes to m article something else. So this is the equivalent scription for the new MVC core way how we write that point.